各位老师、各位同学，大家好，我是黄伟哲市长。疫情期间在家上课，同学们不要忘了，一定要勤洗手，出门戴口罩，保护自己也保护他人。准备好了吗？现在就跟着伟哲市长一起学习有趣的线上课程吧。我们上课喽！
小朋友，我们上课喽！
Hi, boys and girls. Good morning to you. Welcome back to another day all about animals. Are you ready to learn with me? Today, we are going to cover this topic, wild and domestic animals. And we will talk a little bit about something else.And then you will have to do an activity, a very fun activity. Okay, go get your water bottle. It's about to start. Drink some water. Okay, are you ready to start? Now I want you to put your everything's away. Can you tell me what day is today? Today is Friday. Good job, everybody. All right. So today we will talk about all about animals, right? And wild and domestic animals. But before we start, let's do some weather Q&A. How's the weather? You know this question. Always go.How's the weather? It is sunny. Good job. How's the weather? It is rainy. Very good job. How's the weather? It is cloudy. Great job. And how's the weather? It is snowy. When it's snowy, is it hot? No.It is cold. Very good. So now I want you to stand up and we are going to get ready. So we are going to do weather song all together. Please repeat after me. All right. Here we go. Stand up, please. And open your mouth.Sing along with me. Are you ready? Let's move right and left. Right and left. How's the weather? How's the weather? How's the weather today? Is it sunny? Oh, hot. Rainy, my umbrella. Cloudy. How's the weather today?Let's look outside. How's the weather? Is it sunny today? Oh, it's hot. Let's look outside. How's the weather? Is it rainy today? Oh, it's cool. Let's look outside. How's the weather? Is it cloudy today?Let's look outside. It's cold. How's the weather? Go! Weather. How's the weather today? Is it sunny? Rainy. Cloudy. Snowy.Well done, boys and girls. Good job. All right. Now we are back to the... Okay, now go. What day is it? Question mark. Go. What day is it? What day is it? It is Friday. Ooh, today is Friday?I am so happy because Tomorrow will be Saturday, and I don't have to work, and you don't have to do online classes. Very happy! Yay! Weekend is coming. Cool. All right, go one more time. It is Friday. That's right. The 7 days of the week go Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Your turn. Thursday. Good job. Friday. That's right. It's fun, right? And then Saturday. The syllable. Three syllables here. And last one, Sunday. Okay. Come along with me. Go. Monday. Monday. Tuesday. Tuesday. Wednesday. Wednesday. Thursday. Thursday. Friday. Friday. Saturday. Saturday. Sunday. Sunday. Wow, I think now your days of the week is very perfect, right? You can say them just like how you say your name. Good job. Okay, let's also make these seasons of the year very smooth, all right? So I say, you say, go. Summer. Summer is hot. Summer is hot. What about winter? Winter is cold. Good job. What about fall? Teacher Allen, fall is cool. Good job. What about spring? Everyone go. Spring is warm. Wow. Super. Good job, everyone. All right, now let's hit the topic. The topic of today is wild animal and domestic animals. Wild and domestic animals. So, first let's learn about these two words. Wild. What does wild mean? Wild and domestic. Okay, look at these animals. You see them? What kind of animals are they? Wild or domestic? They are wild animals. All right, one more time, go. Wild animals. Wild animals. What does wild animal mean? What does wild mean? These animals are wild. One more time. These animals are wild. Wild. What is wild? Wild animals live without people's help. We don't need to help them. They don't need our help because they can hunt. They can find their food by themselves, right? For example, the leopard, the hawk, the dolphin, the gazelle, monkey, and turtle. They all are able to find their food by themselves. So we don't need to feed them. We don't need to give them food. Dolphin can find fish from the ocean, right? Hawk can hunt, catch other little animals like rat, mouse, maybe little rabbits. Same, turtle can find food by itself. So all these animals are wild. They can find their food by themselves. We don't need to help them. We don't need to feed them. So can you name these animals one more time? Go. Dolphin. Dolphin, that is a water animal. Hawk. Hawk is an air animal. Do you remember? They fly in the sky. Good job. What about next one? Next one is a leopard. That is a wild animal, land animal. On the ground or land animal. Next one is, let me see, gazelle, right? Gazelle is also a wild animal. They are able to find the food by themselves. They eat grass, plants. They're plant eaters. Monkeys, turtles. Monkeys find the food by themselves. They eat coconut, bananas, apples, right? And turtles. Good job. All right, so you know wild animals. What about the second group now? This group is called domestic animals. Can you say that again? Domestic animals. Domestic animals. What are domestic animals? What are they? They are like farm animals, animals that live on the farm. Farm animals and pets. What are pets? Pets are the animals that we can take care of at home, like cats, dogs, and other animals. Pet, right? We can play with them. They are friendly. They don't hurt us, or they won't hurt us. So farm animals and pet are domestic animals. Domestic animals. People feed and care for them. People need to feed them. What is feed? Give them food, right? Give them food. And show care for them. Care for them. Take care of them. Give them place to stay. Give them food. Give them water, right? So these animals are domestic animals. Domestic animals like bird, this kind of bird, because we have different kind of birds, right? But these ones like these type, the small one, and then this one, cow, cat, horse, chicken, and you know more like pigs, dogs, many, many more animals, farm animals, right? Goats. Okay, great. So one more time. Now you know wild animals, people don't need to help them and care for them because they are able to find the food by themselves. They feed themselves. They go hunting. They're strong. They're strong. And then we have domestic animals. People need to find food for them, or people need to care for them and help them, right? For example, we need to feed them. So these are domestic animals. Well done. Okay, now, I want you to learn with me what kind of, or how do we care for domestic animals? Domestic animals need our care, need our help. How can we help domestic animals, right? Take a look. Do you know what is that animal in the picture? It's a very cute cat. What does a cat say?
Meow.
Very good. All right. So, how people need to care for animals, or how do we need to help the domestic animals? Number one, you look at there, the boy feed the cat. We must give them food. If we don't give them food, they will die. All right? We must give them food. Very well done. So the boy is feeding the cat. Feeding the cat. Number two, we must give them water. Very good job. We must give them water. So you remember number one, we must give them food. Number two, we must give them water. You have to say after me. Good job. All right, let's see what else. Look at the boy is brushing the cat. Oh, it shows care. We must keep them clean. We must keep them clean. Very good. They are clean. So we take care of them. We give them shower. We brush their fur. Fur. Do you remember fur? So we must keep them clean. And what about this one? We must give them shelter, right? What is shelter? Like here, a place to stay and a comfortable bed so they can sleep in. And then they can take care of their youngs, their babies, because these animals are able to reproduce. We must give them shelter and a place to have young, right? Or to have youngs, right? The babies, their babies. Very well done. What else? We must give them shelter and a place to have young. What else? Okay. We must play with them because they will get bored, right? We need to make them happy. So go, we must play with them. We need to accompany them, be their friends, play with them, take them out, walk them out, take them to the park. We must play with them. Sometimes they get sick also, right? They also get sick. We have to take them to the animal doctor, a vet. So we must treat them when they are sick. Can you say that again? We must treat them when they are sick. So you see, the poor cat is sick. We have to take him to the vet. The vet is an animal doctor, helps the animal, right, to recover. Okay, great. Next one. Now we are going to talk about two more interesting words in English. All right, we're going to talk about vertebrates and invertebrates. Just very quickly, go again one more time. Vertebrates and invertebrates. You will know why we talk about this. And it's very easy. All right, so every animal's either vertebrate or an invertebrate. All the animals in the world, either they are vertebrates or they are invertebrates or an invertebrate. So can you say the word? Go. Vertebrates. Vertebrates. And invertebrates. Invertebrates. Okay, number one, let's talk about vertebrates. So you see all these animals here are vertebrates. Why are they vertebrates? Teacher Allen tell you. Pay attention. Look at me. Open your ears. Vertebrates have bones inside their bodies. Bone, you know bone? Here, bone, okay, and skeleton, your head. Bone is heart. Vertebrates have bones inside their bodies. Humans, people, monkeys, dogs, horses, frogs, fish, lizards, snakes, and birds are vertebrates. So you see these animals one more time. Do you remember them? Birds, a toucan, lizards or iguanas, fish, horse, frog, monkey, and dog. They are vertebrates. They have bones inside their body. Like this. These are the bones. Okay? A vertebrate bones, vertebrates bones make up its skeleton. Skeleton. Here. Skeleton. Skeleton. This is human skeleton. All right? One more time. Human skeleton. You see all those bones? These are the bones. So human is vertebrate. And here, fish skeleton, and that is bird skeleton. Okay, so one more time with Teacher Alan, please. A vertebrate's bones make up its skeleton. Vertebrates skeletons have a backbone. Backbone. Which other bones are linked? Like here, the backbone. Okay. The skeleton gives the body shape and strength. So what is this skeleton good for? It gives your body shape, the shape, right? That's how I look now, my shape. And also strength, make you strong. Give your body strength, make your body strong. Skeleton gives your body shape and make your body strong. Okay? Clear? What about these animals here you see? Invertebrates. So, invertebrates do not have bones in their body. Some invertebrates, such as insects. Insects, right? Butterfly, grasshopper, okay? That one, right? Like snails, crabs, okay. All right, such as insects and crabs have bodies that are hard on the outside. Hard body. You know what is hard? Not soft. The wood is hard. The rock is hard. Others, such as worms, slugs, squid, and jellyfish have soft body. So jellyfish, squids, all right, slug, okay? But this one is crab. Now, let's say the names of these animals. They are invertebrates. They don't have bones inside their body. Invertebrates. We go there. Butterfly, such as insect. Jellyfish in the water. Crab. Crab has a hard body. Hard shell. Okay. Squid. Squid has no bone. And this one, this guy is a grasshopper. Worms and slugs. These are invertebrates. They don't have what? Bones inside their body. Okay, so can you tell what of these animals, vertebrates, or which one are invertebrates? This one, you can name them. Scorpion. Scorpion. Invertebrates. Snake. Snakes. Invertebrates, okay? Dolphin. Dolphin. Vertebrates. Giraffe. Giraffe. Vertebrates. Octopus. Octopus. Invertebrates. Spider. Spider. Invertebrates. And this guy also invertebrates. Beetle, right? Dung beetle or rhino beetles. That's a rhino beetle. A rhino beetle also has a hard shell, but is invertebrates. Okay? So, vertebrates have bones in their body. Invertebrates have no bone in their body. All right? All right, everyone. Now we have an activity. So to do this activity, We need these materials. Are you ready to say with me? So we need scissors to cut. Scissors, okay? And we also need some straws. You need to get some straws. We also need a glue. That's a glue, white glue. And a black paper. We are going to make a skeleton. You can choose to make human skeleton or you can choose to make any animal skeleton, right? So make sure you get all these materials. Step number one, cut the straws to make the bones, as you see in the shape in the picture, cut the straws. Step number two, glue the bones to the black paper. So we cut the straws and these straws will become the bone. And then we glue them on the black paper to make the skeleton model. Cut out the skill and from the white paper, all right? So are you ready? Are you ready? Let's do it. So now everybody, we are going to make a skeleton, right? I've told you what you need. So now here is my black paper and I have already cut all the straws as you see here. They're all cut nicely. Now let's glue them on the, I am going to make human skeleton. You can make a dog skeleton or you can make a bird skeleton. So I will just glue and then stick on the black paper. Go with me, everyone. All right, let's see. To press this harder. So here we go, let's go faster. Okay, I'm going to put this in the middle. Probably here. Stick, don't move. Okay. Now, I'm going to make like an eye in English. An eye, right? So first, follow me. Yep. Okay, I got this. The glue on it and stick on the paper. Like a big eye. And then one down. This is fun. Let's get some fun together. Okay, so here is my eye is done. Now, I am going to fill in the rib cage. I'll use a different color of straws. You can use white or any color you like. It doesn't matter. So this one, go faster. And then just make it a little bit like this. Tilt a little bit. Okay, and two. Here we are, one more. Three each side. These are the rib cage, the bones. This cage can protect your organs, right? The organs inside. Okay, so I'm gonna put here three more. Maybe you are faster than Teacher Alan. Are you faster than me? Glue. Glue there and stick. Glue and stick. One more to go. So what else do we need? Can you tell me? We need the arms and the legs. Ooh, that is fun. I need the arms and the legs. So for the arms, I'm going to use the same things, the same colors, right? So two arms. One. Attach it from there. Looks very cool, right? And this one over here. Haha, woo! Okay, then. And then the forearm comes down. Ooh. Another forearm. All right. Almost. Now I need two legs, right? One and two. By the way, you can also use double-sided tape. If you don't have this, you can use the double-sided tape. And also, ooh, looking very cool. Another one here. And one little down. You can also make the feet. I don't have space for the feet. The feet should be a little smaller, right? Okay, now, I want just to glue the head here, so I am going to make a little thing here. My neck up, okay, here. And so I'll just make a circle. Just make a circle right there. Ha ha ha. And those are the eyes. What about yours? Did you finish? Very easy. So this is a skeleton. Okay? I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Show me your skeleton, don't forget. And everyone say, thank you, Teacher Alan. Till then, see you next time. Goodbye.
小朋友，用眼30分钟，要记得休息10分钟哦。现在请跟着老师一起来做护眼操吧。首先拿出你的食指，我们先来按压上眼窝，一、二、三、四、五、六、七、八，接着按压你的鼻梁，一、二、三、四、五、六、七、八。再来是下眼窝，一、二、三、四、五、六、七、八，然后是太阳穴，一、二、三、四、五、六、七、八，接着把食指拱起来。我们来按压上眼眶，一、二、三、四、五、六、七、八，再来是下眼眶，一、二、三、四、五、六、七。请伸出你的食指和大拇指，我们一起来按压耳尖，一、二、三、四、五、六、七、八， 耳垂，一、二、三、四、五、六、七、八，我们的护眼操结束喽。